disclaimer, most of these products are actually not that bad, they just did not work out for me, and I will explain why, so hear me out. And as in the previous video, I will put the timestamps down below so that you can just watch the part of the video with the product that you are interested in. So the first product that I have for you is the Hyaluron Filler SPF 30, the cream meant for all skin types. Okay, so first of all, this isn't a bad cream. This is actually a good cream, but it just did not work out for me. And it could have easily ended up in the previous video with the products that I love, but the reason that I included it in this video is just because I never bought another packaging, and I probably never will because I cannot use it in the winter, I cannot use it in the summer. I will explain why, just hear me out. First of all, it's a good cream. As all other hyaluron filler creams, this one has high and low molecular hyaluronic acid. As you know already, low molecular hyaluronic acid can penetrate deeper layers of the skin and can, you know, reduce wrinkles, and the high molecular hyaluronic acid sits on the outermost layer of the skin and hydrates it. It also has glycine saponin, that is the active ingredient that is stimulating the production of the hyaluronic acid in your skin. It does have alcohol listed in the fourth place, but that's not a deal breaker for me. I don't mind that. Alcohol is a penetration enhancer and it makes those lightweight formulations, and this is a very lightweight formulation. It has great sensor characteristics and it spreads out really easily on the skin. So this cream is SPF 30 and it has UVA protection. And when I look at the filters, yes, it does have both UVA and UVB filters. My problem with this cream is that, first of all, I used it at the time when I was using the Knight's peeling and serum. That one had AHAs and that one was making my skin more sensitive to sunlight. So whenever a product is making your skin more sensitive to sunlight, you will want to wear a sunscreen with it. So I was wearing a sunscreen and I was wearing this sunscreen, but was it enough? I'm not sure. Honestly, I'm not sure if it was enough because it does not have a UVA rating. So we do have UVB rating, that is SPF. It's SPF 30, that is high protection. It's great. But then again, I don't know how high the UVA protection is, and it does not have a broad spectrum claim. So I don't even know if the UVA protection is at least 1/3 of the claimed UVB protection, because if a sunscreen has a broad spectrum claim, that means that the UVA protection is at least 1/3 of the UVB protection. Now here, there is no broad spectrum cream. So because of this, this isn't making it a bad cream. It's a good cream, good anti-aging cream, but it has to be layered. You have to wear a sunscreen and then layer this one on top. And by the way, that is also stated on Eucerin's website. So I love Eucerin because they don't have misleading claims. They actually have a claim on their website. It might be necessary to use another sunscreen with this cream, which is great. Great claim, nothing misleading here. There you go, so you can decide for yourself, do you want to layer it or not? I would not have a problem with layering, by the way. Here's where my problem is going. This is way too complicated. Hopefully you're following me. Hopefully you're still following. So I don't have a problem with layering it. I would gladly layer it over a sunscreen, but here's the problem. In the summer, it's too much. It's too much for my skin. I don't need that much moisture in the summer, so I cannot layer it in the summer. And then in the winter, it's not moisturizing enough for me, so I cannot use it in the winter either. So that's the thing. I would prefer the version of this cream that is meant for dry skin, logically, because I have dry skin. And that's it. The only thing that is necessary to know about this cream is that you should layer it. You shouldn't rely on it as your main sun protection during the day. And yeah, that's it. No drama, no tea spilling, no nothing. It's a good anti-aging cream. It just didn't work out for me because I have dry skin. And it probably will work out for you if you have normal skin or even combination oily. Normal skin types or combination oily will benefit the most with layering, but of course in the winter. Or in the summer, you won't even need to layer it. So there you go. I would recommend this cream for normal or combination oily as a top layer in the winter. Yeah, but I wouldn't recommend that you rely solely on this cream as your main sun protection, and not even Eucerin is recommending that. So I mean, I respect Eucerin for having such non-misleading claims. They have non-misleading claims. Their claims are really authentic and true. So yeah, no drama, no spilling the tea. It's a good anti-aging cream. It just didn't work out for me because I do have dry skin, and yeah, so there you go. There you go. Okay, so next up we have the Hyaluron Filler CC SPF 15 Day Cream Light Version. But I actually tried both the light version and the dark version, and neither worked out for me. And I will explain why, of course. So the good thing about these creams is that these don't have samples. So if you're not sure, you can always just get a sample and test it out for a couple of days and then decide whether or not you're going to buy it. So that's what I did. I actually never bought this product. I only used the samples, and the samples did not work out for me. So I never bought the whole packaging. It is what it is. Okay, so here's the thing. This is another anti-aging day cream by User. It also has hyaluronic acid. As always, both low molecular and high molecular hyaluronic acid. Also has glycine saponin that I already mentioned stimulates the production of hyaluronic acid in your skin. And it does have UV filters. Yeah, it has a lower protection here. UVB protection is SPF 15, not a lot. So you will have to layer it. And then it does have UVA protection, but again, no UVA rating. So we don't know how high the UVA protection is. Because of all of this, you will again have to layer the sunscreen. This will not be enough protection on its own. You have to wear sunscreen first and then this on top. So that's not even a deal breaker for me. I always have a separated sunscreen. I by the way use La Roche-Posay Shaka Fluid. That's my fave. I will put a link right here. I did a review on it and I'm still using it religiously. So the deal breaker for me is that this CC cream does not have enough coverage to make it worth buying.
Just for the reference, I did get this CC cream in the darker version. I got the sample just to show you the effect on the skin. So here is the effect on the skin. It does not provide you with a lot of coverage, but it does give you a luminous finish. So I like that, but just the coverage isn't enough for me. But again, take a look at this footage and be your own judge what you think. Is this enough for you or not?
Yeah, it's not covering enough, so I would rather buy a regular Hyaluron Filler Day Cream for dry skin because I really love their line for dry skin. Anything that is for dry skin from Eucerin is amazing for dry skin. So I would rather buy a regular Hyaluron Filler for dry skin. If I have to layer, I will layer it on top, and then I will put a little bit of foundation if I need coverage, or a little bit of concealer. Or if I'm going for that lightweight CC cream or BB cream look, then I have a little trick that I use. I mix a little bit of moisturizer with a little bit of foundation, and that's how I create that lightweight effect on my skin. So yeah, that's the thing. This CC cream from Eucerin does not provide me with enough coverage to make it worth buying for me, and that's it. But then again, you can always get a sample. Get a sample just to be sure. Maybe you will like the effect that I don't like. We're all different, we all have different skin types, and we all have different expectations of the skincare that we're using. So yeah, I guess my recommendation would be just to get a sample to be sure if this CC cream will work out for you or not. Okay, so then we have the Hyaluron Filler Sheet Mask. Again, it's not a bad sheet mask. It's just that I don't like sheet masks. That's it. Here's the thing. So this sheet mask is made of biocellulose, and that is great. That biocellulose material just sticks to your face. It's not moving around at all. So that's great. It's soaked in product. And what is a sheet mask? So sheet mask is a piece of material soaked in serum. And that's what you get here. You have a piece of material made of biocellulose soaked in serum. And the serum contains two actives. You have hyaluronic acid and you have glycerin, and that's it. No more actives here. You also don't have any alcohol. It's non-comedogenic, lightly fragranced. So the only two actives that you get here are the glycerin and hyaluronic acid. Of course, hyaluronic acid comes in two forms, both low molecular and the high molecular hyaluronic acid, as with most Eucerin's products. Okay, so it's a good mask. It gives you a lot of hydration to the skin. Just make sure that you lock all of that hydration into place by applying an occlusive-based moisturizer right away after using this mask. I think that is really necessary to preserve that effect of the mask. So bottom line is, it's a good mask. So here's the problem that I have with sheet masks. You're going to pay for this one in particular around $25 for only 4 sheet masks. Okay, you can totally do that if you don't have a budget. As far as I'm concerned, I don't mind. You can pamper yourself. You can, you know, why not? I mean, if you don't have a budget, go ahead, buy it. Why not? It's just that when it comes to my money, I like to invest in serums. So I would rather buy the Hyaluron Filler Night Peeling and Serum. This one right here, I also have a review on it. I would rather buy that one, and because that one also has glycerin and hyaluronic acid, it's going to give you that hydration, and it also has AHAs, all the fruit acids, so it's going to, you know, give you a more intense anti-aging effect, and it's going to last you for a longer time. Yeah, because you get 40 milliliters in there. You know, it's just how I view things. Don't get me wrong, if Eucerin sends me a package of this sheet masks, I'm going to use it, don't worry. I will use it for sure. But again, if you don't have a budget and you like to pamper yourself every now and then with a sheet mask, go ahead, be my guest, why not? It's a good sheet mask, it's not a bad sheet mask. Okay, so now we have the Elasticity Filler SPF 15 Under Eye Cream. Now, I do have a full video review on this one. You can check it out right here in case you want a more detailed information on why I didn't like the cream. And I will just go through the main stuff right here. So I have two reasons why I didn't like it. Let's go through the good stuff first. So this one also has high and low molecular hyaluronic acid. It also has arctin, and this is the active ingredient that is accelerating the collagen renewal in the cells. It also has some protection. We have SPF 15 and we also have UVA protection. Again, there's no UVA rating, so we don't know how high the UVA protection is, but hey, it has both UVA and UVB protection. Most of the under eye creams don't have that, so I don't want to be too picky here, okay? Anyways, the reason why I didn't like this cream. So first reason is that it wasn't really easily spreadable, and it was kind of leaving a sticky finish around the eye area. For me, it wasn't the best option to wear underneath makeup. That's one reason. And the second reason is, I guess the more important one, is that it was stinging my eyes like crazy. And my eyes were watering when I was using this product. So you will see in this review that I already did. So at first it was really intense, my eyes were watering. Then after a while I got used to it, so I again was using it for a while. And then again it worsened, so eventually I just gave up on it and yeah, I stopped using it completely. And I went back to this Sebamed Q10 lifting eye cream that I love and that I have been using for over 2 years now. And I go back to this one religiously. I really love the effect on the skin. It's such a lightweight formulation, spreads out really easily, moisturizes so well, and looks great underneath makeup. This one makes your makeup look better. Concealer looks better on top of this. So that's why I love this one. So the only thing is that this one does not have any UVB or UVA filters. You don't have sun protection with this one. So here's how I worked around that. During the day, I'm using this La Roche-Posay Shaka Fluid for around the eye area, because this one can be applied around the eye area and it does not sting. So that's what I use during the day. And then in the evening, I use the Sebamed Q10 Lifting Eye Cream. And that's how I, yeah, that's just what works for me for now. Personally, I couldn't handle the Elasticity Filler Under Eye Cream, so I just gave up on it. Okay, and the last product that I have for you today is the Dermataclean Cleansing Milk. Okay, now this is the older version. They do have a new version of this that is called Hyaluron Dermataclean, something like that. So here's the thing why I didn't like this one. First of all, I think that I would have loved this like back in 2012, when I was a broke college student. I think I would have loved it. Back then, I was using all kinds of milk cleansers and milk makeup removers. That's what I was into. I don't think there were as many cleansing products back then as there are now. So back then, I would have loved it. But today, when there are so many better options for me in particular, I just don't find it practical anymore. This cleansing milk has mild surfactants, it has no fragrance, it does have 2 to 3 potentially comedogenic ingredients, but if you have dry skin, you won't even mind that. You won't even have a problem with that. So my point is, if you have dry and sensitive skin, this might work out for you. Again, this isn't going to dissolve heavy makeup. Don't expect from it that it's going to remove heavy makeup. You know, it's just not what it is intended for. This product is meant for people with dry and sensitive skin. And by the way, you're supposed to use this milk with a toner. First, you're going to cleanse your face with this milk, and then you need to remove traces of the milk with a toner. Now, I don't have that Eucerin toner, but I used this one. It's just a toner that I had. at the moment. So I'm not claiming any claims on this one. So anyways, for me, that's a little bit too much work, you know, milk and then cleanser, and it's not even going to remove makeup. So I hope that you understand why this product isn't working out for me. But then again, you know, if you have dry and sensitive skin, then this might work out for you. It might work out for you. And if you wonder what I prefer this Dermatoclean Hyaluron Foam. I love this one. It's from the same line, Dermatoclean. It's super gentle, does not dry out my skin. And I use this as a double cleansing. I already mentioned this one in the previous video, so go watch that previous video right here if you want to hear my full opinion on this micellar foam. So yeah, hopefully this video wasn't too negative, and hopefully I explained well enough why these products did not work out for me. Hopefully I was clear enough. As always, please take into consideration everything that I've said so far in this video, and then be your own judge, figure out what these products maybe work out for you. So yeah, there you have it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.